it's probably more important than ever that brands are focusing on business outcomes. I know we've always always talked about the importance of that, but given a lot of the uncertainties sort of in our world now, socially and politically, business-wise, really focusing marketing dollars on business outcomes, I think is more important than ever before, but not just in performance marketing. I think we're talking about everything from brand affinity to all the way through sales. In other words, the full funnel. I think brands are still looking for the classics, you know, driving awareness, consideration, intent to purchase, all those classic metrics. But now they're really looking to see and measure engagement, online action, conversion to online and offline sales. So again, it's the full funnel and not just looking at sort of performance marketing and the bottom of the funnel. So I think that the escalation of certainly fueled by the pandemic of e-commerce, the changes associated with Google eliminating cookies, Apple limiting the use of data on their phones. There's a lot going on in the industry that requires marketers to focus more on outcomes than I think they ever have.
So Wenda, where are some of those tools? What's the expectation of the industry? And where is sort of the blind spot or the gap in terms of measurement? And I know you've joined the LoopMe advisory board, but you know, tell us sort of you know, where the holes are, where they should be filled.
Well, I think, you know, with continued fragmentation, you know, more than ever before, I think marketers are looking for attribution across all of the different channels, and certainly, you know, looking at the change that that the pandemic has brought on with consumer behavior as it pertains to building brands and to completing sales, looking at the change in the customer journey. I think that's a very important issue right now, given that using particularly digital online marketing, you know, not just for bottom of the funnel, but understanding all the way, you know, top down, what does that consumer journey look like? And how do I build brand and create transactions all the way through? So I think the attribution issue continues to be tantamount. I think one of the things that, you know, we've sort of been all data crazy. I can't even remember how many years it is now that we, you know, coined that term, you know, big data, and, you know, now we're big data, media data, little data, anything. It's all data driven. But I think it's also how you use that data. And you mentioned LoopMe, which I think is a really, really interesting company that is not only leveraging data, but it's using that data married with AI to go into real time, right while a campaign is happening, and be able to make adjustments and to produce better results. So I think that's one of the challenges that marketers have had, is they're still getting, you know, sort of post campaign reports. What a company like LoopMe does is sort of right while that campaign is happening, leverage the data insights that they have through their partnerships, add the AI, and they can adjust that campaign in real time and bring in, you know, better targets and net new customers. So I think that's, you know, it's really literally closing the loop. And I think that we've all been looking for that for a long time. So that's one of the things that interests me about this company, is that it's really providing a set of solutions to problems that have still challenged marketers, despite the fact that we have all the data. It's got to be used to provide better outcomes, and that's what they've proven to do. And I think that's certainly one of the key challenges.
Now, Wenda, you've been a publisher, you've been on the sell side, you've consulted to many publishing companies. What is the challenge for publishers to show the efficacy of what they do? We've talked about brands and brands wanting that. Where does the publisher fit into that scenario?
Yeah, I think it's been a challenge for publishers for many years now to prove the importance of their content and the context within which they're presenting that content. And while, you know, we've certainly moved to buying audiences more than buying titles, if you will, it's very important for the publishers to justify their investment in the content that they're producing. And in a world that is so driven by scale and by data, it's sometimes challenging for them to find their voice and convince buyers that what they do and what they produce is in fact differentiated and often worth an incremental price that they charge. So I think, you know, with the big four rising above the noise that they create has been a real challenge. And then that move to buying audiences versus buying content. So like everything else, you know, somehow we meet in the middle, but rising above the focus solely on scale has been a challenge.
Wenda, it's been a very rough year, very rough for all of us on some level. But for the industry, there's been a lot of innovation and a lot of progress. And in some ways, perhaps accelerated by the pandemic. I wanted to ask you what you think are some exciting trends to watch in the new year, some developments that have sort of been in the works, and what you're excited about.
Well, I'm excited like everybody else to just have a new year. I think if 2020 were a fish, I'd throw it back. I'm sure you would too. So I think there's a lot to look forward to. I think from an industry standpoint, I mentioned before the difference in the consumer journey now. I think what's going to be fun is to watch how brands decide to connect with consumers in this very changed environment and what it means to be an authentic brand, building your business and really having a relationship with the consumer that is respectful of these times. And I think during this past year, you know, so many marketers did a great job of respecting what was going on with the pandemic, but also in building their business. So I think we're going to see new relationships created and new ways to reach the consumer. And so for me, reach the consumer emotionally. And so that to me is the most exciting thing that I see on the horizon.